mighty angels of God has been now stationed and taken their positions around the world in many, many important oceans.
In the Pacific Ocean,
I saw these angels taking up positions everywhere.
Huge mighty angels.
Over the Pacific Ocean.
Pacific Samaga Samuthrathinmel.
The South China Sea region.
Let me accurately tell you where exactly in geographical position he is stationed.
There is an island in the Pacific Ocean called Samoa.
Put one point there.
And draw a line straight up to Japan.
Angirundhu Japan varaikkum oru neer kodu varayengal.
And draw a line straight down to the Solomon Islands.
Keele Solomon Thivugalukku varai oru keel kodu varayengal.
And then join it to back to Samoa Island.
Meendumaya the Samoa Thivodu kuda inaitthu oru kodu varayengal.
You will have a triangle.
Oru mukkona vadivam ippadu ungalukku kidaithirukkum.
That is where he is stationed.
And facing towards the Asian nations.
Akkarargal.
The Asian nations including Australia and New Zealand.
God shakes the heaven.
God shakes the heaven.
That's what happened that day in 2004.
One more time it will happen again.
That is why those angels are positioned and stationed in the Pacific Ocean.
One more time it's going to take place.
Here God.
The hour of his judgment has come.
Mahal na araw, may magandang balitang hatid sa Pilipinas ang isang respetadong Indian prophet na dumalaw sa bansa para sa pagdiriwang ng tinaguriang Jubilee of Jubilees ng bansa ngayong taon. Makakaligtas daw tayo sa isa pang malaking trahedya sa dagat tulad ng tsunami na tatama sa Asia. Pero may mga kailangan tayong gawin. Alamin sa pagpapatrol ni Israel Malasa.
Sa propesiya ng respetadong Indian prophet na si Brother Sadhu Sundal Salvara, sinabi niyang may panibagong trahedya tulad ng tsunami ang magaganap sa Asia. Pero ang good news, makakaligtas daw ang Pilipinas. Kailangan lang magkaisa ang iba-ibang simbahan sa bansa sa pamamagitan ng tatlong araw na National Day of Prayer and Fasting.
What God wants you to be, to cry for the sins that the land has committed during the past 490 years.
Payo ng propeta, mahalaga ang sakripisyo ng pag-aayuno para maisalba ang Pilipinas sa tiyak na kapahamakan.
Typhoons and the hurricanes and the sea waves are waiting to come and crush the land. There is a place called Mindanao. Yes. And below that strait there is a place called
Amigosa.
The Lord said that there has been appointed a typhoon to come upon that area. He will surround the place called Targa. And the foundations will be shaken. Many people will die. It will be a big lesson and a fear to the rest of the world. A huge number of people will be scattered. You may have to depend on the nations of the world to help you. The Lord has kept it reserved for a mighty typhoon to rise up again in this land. God's anger will come upon the islands of Samar and between. A huge typhoon is planned to come over there. There will be disaster through flood. A great flood and great typhoon will come upon Palawan. Many people dying there. There are hundreds of places waiting to be flooded in the Philippines. There are the smells of water in many of your places in your land. Lord says, death is coming by water. A great, grievous death is coming to Palawan. Grievous death is going to come to Mindanao. The Lord is going to pour his bowl of blood upon these places. They are meant. There's the smell of water in many places of your land. Many people will be drowned. Maybe you may have faced many types of danger, but this coming danger will be great in the eyes of the world. Hundreds and thousands of people will be scattered. Many houses will be ravaged. Many people will be refugees in their own land. A very pitiful state will come upon you, where you will have to depend on other people to help you. Children will die of hunger, of pain, and of water. Many children's bodies will be thrown in the streets. Many areas will become muddy and swampy. Many great dangers will surround your nation. Lord says your rivers will come upon the land. At the place of Kangasuna, the Lord says it is in the northernmost part of your land. From there, grievous disease will spread all over the world. That will consume the flesh of man. All their upper skin will begin to decay. It will pierce to the bones. The fear of this disease will spread all over the world. The Lord says this will begin from the Philippines. It will then spread to Cebu. Another new disease will spring up from Cebu. The Lord says another disease will come from Boko. It will be a challenge to your nation. This disease will spread very widely so that every people will fear. It will spread all over the land and then it will spread into many nations of the world. When this disease spreads to man, it will cause the man's body to turn black. Many old people's bodies will burst. Their bodies will decay and become rock. People will be afraid to bury such people. The Lord says such plagues will come to surround your land. There's going to come mighty floods in Luzon and Cebu. It will come as a result of winds and the water. All these dangers will come that history has never seen before. All your irrigatable land will be destroyed. That country are going to stretch out your begging hands for food from other nations. Your children are going to die of famine and hunger. 70 islands of your nation are waiting to be disappeared underwater. The water will rise up against them. The shouts and the cries of the people will be very terrible. The waters around the coastal cities will pass over the coastal cities and enter into the land. Many people lose their property. Many people take away in sunlight and land. Earthquakes will come in your land. Volcanoes will erupt in many places. There will be cries and troubles in the land. These are all the grievous changes that God has against your land. Okay, your young people will become captives. The hunters and the captors will increase in your land. Wicked people walk in the streets of your land. They will kill many people in broad daylight and throw their bodies in the streets. There will even come a dangerous times when people kill each other for food. The Lord says many buildings will catch fire. God will set many buildings with fire and shaking. God will cause dangers to come through lightnings and thunder. These are all the dangers, disasters that God has sent for this nation. Even then, God says, but all these will only come to pass if you walk away from God. If you will consider me during these days of grace, you will turn your face and repent to tells me if you rise up from the slip of character, nothing of this gentle come upon your life. I will find them. I will turn the wind away. I will scatter the diseases. I will cause your irrigation land to be fertile. I will cause a hundredfold of your fruits. Therefore, my beloved nation, the great, these days of grace that I've given to you, it is important for you to make a quick decision. These are the good things that I care for your land. You must choose between the good things I care for you or the work that I care for you. I have given a short time for you. I am calling the churches to repent. Oh Philippines, I have stretched out my wings and I'm waiting for you. As the chicken will get, as a ham will get a chicken, I am waiting to hide you under my knees. Hear you, stand into my voice. I will cause rain for goodness to come upon you. There will be health in his nature of the nation of your blessed nation in the eyes of the world. You will bear my voice to the rest of the world. You will be called by my name as my people. I will bear you up by my right hand. I will lift up your young people. Therefore, remember these days that I have given to you. How long more must I continually speak to you? Oh, my ministers, how many times must I tell you to repent? Repent towards me. There is grace and peace with me. I am calling you to bind your wounds. I am calling you to lift you up. I am calling you to protect you from the dangers to come. Even because of the established border in this place, I see the Lord standing in your midst. There is some kind of sentence in his eye. He is standing before you with two stretched out hands. Oh, my beloved nation, who can see your children? Who can see your flesh being consumed? Who can see your children begging for bread? If you would be careless to break into the blessing I have for you, just think for a moment who has this one to save you. Which nation will weep for you? Which nation will share bread with you? Which nation will open its door for you? There is none. Therefore, I desire that today you will repent. I am standing in your midst. Oh, church, listen to my words. Enough of dangling in the affairs of the world. Enough of running after useless things. Enough of wasting your precious time and strength on needless things. I have forgotten the days of your ignorance. But now I expect you to know. Therefore, nation, I have sent my prophet in your midst. It is I who spoke through them. It is not the voice of a man. It is my message that I will lead. The eye of the Lord upon you. He is seeking for those who are seeking for the land. Is there anyone who is standing again? You must cry and weep. There you are, the Lord. Oh, weep and mourn like a mother who lost a child. Weep like a wife who lost a husband. If the nation is perished, where will you go? If you lose the great blessing, like what God has kept for you, what a pitiful people you are. I believe you to wash away all your sins. I desire that even now, from now on, you'll be faithful to your bridegroom. Cry for your sins. Give your tears as your offering. O Philippines nation, let your tears be offered as offering into the bowl of the angels that come to bring them to heaven. Your tears and your prayer and your mourning, truly, I say unto you, it will protect your nation. Let the gentleness rise up. Let the gentleness rise up. I will deliver no longer. Based on the decisions you will make, the future of your nation will rest upon it. Lord, I got to send this to you. I am the Lord who called you, says the Lord.